I personally feel like it's to do with the imagery that the brand like portrays, and I think it tries to like, I don't know, get over to its audience that is rebelling against society, I guess, and I think a lot of people can relate to that. Instead of brands, like other brands, I guess, they kind of like stick to what they know and are scared to find out what could happen if they go against the norm. And I think Dr. Martens as a brand, like, it does that because obviously, like, you've got your studded boots, you've got like your tartan boots, you've got all sorts really. And I think standing for something is really vital for the company itself. What put Dr. Martens on the map and made it so iconic was all the different subcultures that kind of grew with it. First of all, Dr. Martens were like brought up for police, they were like made for working boots for like the police force. And then it kind of, not really got out of hand, but it like took to the new level, like mods were wearing them, punks were wearing them, hippies were wearing them. And I think subcultures, I think anyway, kind of make Britain what it is today. I think that's what makes it so iconic. I think it defines Britain itself. Like, it's nice to say, oh yeah, we're a brand that's like, yeah, they're still made in England. Like, it still plays a massive part to it. I mean, fashion is forever growing as well. And I think Dr. Martens is trying to keep up with that too. Mm-hmm. So yeah, it's definitely important. Yes, definitely, especially because nowadays brands tend to move overseas for efficiency, I guess, and to get their hands on different materials. So when people do look to like buying products in the UK, it's vital that the quality is top notch, especially that it's not a lot of people making the UK these days. It's become more simplistic, I'd say. Like all the accessories, I think people are like cutting it down, and designs and patterns have become more simplistic in that sort of sense, I guess. Like there's not much going on. And like I think if you wanted to make a statement, you'd probably wear something simple, like a really nice cut shirt with, I don't know, some funky trousers and then like statement shoes. So I think it's kind of like simplified itself out. When we first started out, it was more like 1461s and 1460s, like boots and shoes. And now the company's kind of progressed. It's kind of like looking at different materials or going to different parts of the world and sourcing, God knows what we can get our hands on, like ostrich level or something, for example. And we've also like catered to kids, and now we're opening up our clothing range. So I do think it is becoming bigger, a lot bigger. We'll be right back.